Kayla, I'll never forget the first time I laid my eyes on you. The way your joy was contagious, the way your smile could light up a dark room, the way your laughter could make anyone's days better, and to be honest, how smoking hot you were. I remember telling my teammates that day that you were off limits because I was going to marry you. I remember telling my parents, guys, I met my dream girl. They replied, what does she think about that? I said, well, she doesn't know that I exist yet, but she will. So I shot my shot, and you ghosted me. So I shot again, and you ghosted me, again. Thank God I couldn't take a hint. When I finally convinced you to go on a date with me, I remember being so nervous. I fixed myself up as much as I knew how to, only to see you walk out of your dorm in sweatpants and a hoodie, fresh out of soccer practice, vulnerable, confident, in yourself. From there, my heart was hooked. I remember being so comfortable with you the moment you stepped foot in my car. I remember talking about all my dreams, my ambitions, and my priorities, things that would typically scare a girl off. I even played my anthem, I'm Sexy and I Know It, within the first 20 minutes. And you're still here. I, for the first time, felt truly accepted for me. I didn't have to put up walls or a front. I simply just had to be me, and that was enough for you. You're my biggest encourager, my biggest motivator, and you refuse to let me give up on my crazy dreams. More importantly, you push me to be a better man every single day. I admire everything about you. I admire your positivity. I admire your love for people, and I admire your willingness to help others. I can't wait to walk this life alongside of you. I can't wait to see the mother you are to our children. Can't wait to see the things that you do for God's kingdom. I vow to encourage you, I vow to support you, I vow to love you, and I vow to be the leader of our family that is honoring to both you and God, forever and always.
Caleb Truth Wallace, you're the answer to my prayers. You've exceeded every expectation and dream I've ever had. God knew exactly what my heart needed when he gave me you. You're my best friend. You push me to be the best version of myself. You love me for who I am, and I am so deeply in love with you. I remember our first date so well. We got dinner at Archinetti's and then Oreo Blizzards from Dairy Queen, your favorite. I mostly remember looking over at you on our drive back and knowing you were the one. I knew you were the one for me because of your love for the Lord. Through our relationship, you have shown me Jesus' love, his grace, his patience, and his joy to me. So today, as we become one, I vow to do the same for you. I will run fully toward Jesus every single day of my life. I will seek him first and learn to love you better each day. I vow to love, honor, and respect you. I vow to support you as you pursue your God-given dreams. I vow to build you up and cover you in prayer. Wherever life brings us, I will be right here with you. I vow to pray with you, laugh with you, and be with you through all the highs and lows this life will bring. I can't wait to walk back down the aisle knowing I have the privilege of loving you for the rest of my life.
Oh, the veil's coming off.
You look beautiful. Oh, my little girl. My little girl. I love you too. I'm glad you got everything you wanted. He's a good guy. He's a good guy. Don't cry. I'm very happy for you. Love you.
I love you.
Hey, babe. How are you?
I'm good. How are you?
Good. How do you feel?
I feel great.
You ready?
I'm so excited. I'm ready. I'm so ready. How was your day?
Good, honestly. I didn't start getting ready till like noon.
I figured.
You ready to pray?
I'm ready.
Dear Heavenly Father, we just come to you today feeling extremely humble, blessed, and just thankful, Lord. We ask that your hand will be upon this whole day, Lord, and the rest of our life. We pray that everything that we do will honor and glorify you, Lord, and we pray that you would use us in a way that pleases you, Lord, and furthers your kingdom. We ask that you would be along with us every step of the way, Lord, and we know you will. We are so thankful. We love you. We praise you. Everything we do, we want you to be at the center of, Lord. It's in your name we pray. Amen.
Amen.
Dearly beloved, we are gathered here at the sight of God to join together this man and this woman in holy matrimony.
Didn't know that I'd fall.
It is an honorable estate, institute of God, signifying unto us the mystical union that
gravity
is between
Christ and his church.
That holy estate Christ adorned and beautified with his presence.
I come up against myself.
Demons in my head. It is commended in the scriptures to be honorable. I don't know how you do. Therefore, it's not by any to be entered into unadvisedly or lightly, but reverently.
I step among the who
advisedly,
if I never found you and you never found me.
To this holy estate, these two persons present come now. Be
so won't you give
who gives this woman to marry this man?
And the rest of
Caleb, will you have this woman to be your wife? To live together after God's ordinance on the holy estate of matrimony. Will you love her, comfort her, honor and keep her in sickness and in health, forsaking all others,
I'll
keep thee only and never so
by
long
side.
As you go shall. Caleb, will you have this man to be your wedded husband? Live together after God's ordinance in the holy estate of matrimony. Will you love him, comfort him, honor him, and keep him in sickness and in health, forsaking all others, keep thee only unto him, so long as you both shall live.
I do.
If you ever I, Caleb.
I, Caleb.
Take thee, Caleb.
Take thee, Caleb.
To be my wedded wife.
To be my wedded wife.
To have and to hold.
To have and to hold.
From this day forward.
From this day forward.
For better, for worse.
For better, for worse.
For richer, for poor.
For richer, for poor.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
To love and to cherish.
To love and to cherish.
Till death do us part.
Till death do us part.
I, Caleb.
I, Caleb.
Take thee, Caleb.
Take thee, Caleb.
To be my wedded husband.
To be my wedded husband.
To have and to hold.
To have and to hold.
From this day forward.
From this day forward.
For better, for worse.
For better, for worse.
For richer, for poor.
For richer, for poor.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
To love and to cherish.
To love and to cherish.
Till death do us part.
Till death do us part.
Caleb, would you please?
Yes,
repeat after me with this ring.
With this ring.
I thee wed.
I thee wed.
In the name of the Father.
In the name of the Father.
And of the Son.
And of the Son.
And the Holy Spirit.
And the Holy Spirit.
With this ring.
With this ring.
I thee wed.
I thee wed.
In the name of the Father.
In the name of the Father.
And the Son.
And the Son.
And the Holy Spirit.
The Spirit.
Biblical. It's biblical. So won't you give me tonight?
I pronounce that they are husband and wife in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Caleb, you may kiss.
So come on and give me tonight and the rest of your life. I want to have it all with you. I want to have it all with you. And when you open your eyes, oh, I'll be there.
The person I've always looked up to and who understands me more than anyone, I'm so proud of you. It's been the greatest privilege to grow up with you for the last 16 years, even if I do not remember it. Thank you, Caleb, for being everything I could ever want, best friend. Now to Caleb, the man that has chosen to marry my wonderful sister. Thank you. You are by far one of the kindest and most genuine souls I have encountered. Seeing how much you love and care for Kayla fills my heart to the brim. Whether you two are dancing, laughing, or even just sitting on the couch, the way you look at Kayla says it all. I'm so excited to watch God do amazing things in your new lives together.
Everyone loves a good love story. Somehow you managed to trick this woman, the woman of your dreams, into a first date. Shortly after, you brought this girl home to meet your mother and I. Your mother and I quickly realized what it was about Kayla that made your heart leap. Little did I know that you, Kayla, were indeed the girl that my wife and I had been praying about and praying for since Caleb was a little boy. Kayla, the Bible says that every good and perfect gift comes from our Heavenly Father. No doubt you are a gift to our family. You have purpose. You have a calling upon your life. Remember that Jesus is the author and he is the perfecter of your faith. He is the author of this love story. Let him write your story as you continue to pursue him and watch what amazing and incredible things will happen. No matter what life throws at you, no matter what you do, don't stop turning the pages. because God is writing new words each and every day. Caleb, it was my deepest honor when you asked me to be your best man. I'll rebound for you on the basketball court, and I'll rebound for you in life.
Kayla, my little girl, you are all grown up now. It happened so fast. Kayla, I am so proud of you and the woman you've become. Your smile and personality are electric. They're both a gift from God. Do you remember when I told you that you were a real catch? Remember that? And that you deserve someone really special. I was right, wasn't I? What I've been living for. Today proves that. You both are so incredibly blessed. I can't wait to see what God has for you both. Whatever it is, it's going to be great. There comes a time when a daddy has to let his little girl go. It's my time to let my little birdie, another nickname, stretch out her wings and fly away. It's your time to begin your new family. It has been an honor and an amazing blessing to be your daddy, and I will love you forever. Thank you.